Hello there, Professor. First time to Pendleton? It's as close as you can get to Nye County without actually having to step foot in it. You're going to be familiar with our victim, Manuel Molinas.
Drug dealer we just arrested for the murder of Jessica Marnier. He's connected to Beatrice Salazar. What's he doing in a Pendleton jail cell?
A few years back, feds decided they needed a facility to handle their more sensitive prisoner transfers in and out of the Southwest United States. Someplace off the radar. Someplace like Pendleton. So they wrote a big check to the town council and upgraded their existing jailhouse in exchange for occasionally taking over the place. Our tax dollars at work.
I thought this building looked a little too metropolitan for a town of 35. Isn't that officer one of ours?
Yes, he is, but Sergeant Lipp's been tapped before by the feds to coordinate this kind of transfer. Their plan was to quietly move Molinas out of our lockup and into this undisclosed location, then hold him here until he could be interviewed by a federal prosecutor and formally transferred into federal custody.
Not a bad plan. I wonder what went wrong.
Looks like everything.
Looks like everything. Ganz genau. Doch jetzt werden wir alles auflösen.
Okay, I don't need to tell you. This is now priority number one. Molinas' transfer was on a need-to-know basis. The first I heard of it, the sheriff and the deputy director of the FBI had me on the speakerphone, screaming that somebody dropped the ball. So I got my ass out of there and secured the scene.
Is Agent Huntby still missing?
Yes. And based on his apparent effort to sabotage your handling of the DNA evidence in the Salazar case, the FBI strongly suspects he was a mole for Salazar, and now officially considers his disappearance UFAP.
Unlawful flight to avoid prosecution, meaning he's a fugitive, and very likely a suspect in this homicide. Sergeant Lipp should consider himself a very lucky man. Whoever broke in here to silence Molinas wouldn't have wanted to leave a living witness. We'll need to get a full statement from him.
Ja, dann wollen wir doch mal unseren Herrn Lips hier befragen, bevor wir uns den Tatort genauer anschauen. Ich weiß nicht, ob man den Hamster gerade im Hintergrund hört, aber der dreht voll am Laufrad ab.
Hey,
Sergeant Lipp, I'm Ray Langston. My partner and I are with the Las Vegas Crime Lab.
Yeah, great. But please call me Tim. This is just a spectacular screw-up.
Okay. Und ich möchte es ja nur erwähnen. Wir haben im zweiten Fall oder im ersten Fall auf dieser Baustelle Asus gehabt. Wir hatten im allerersten Fall Asus bei dieser Frau in diesem in ihrem eigenen Wohnung. Wir hatten im letzten Fall Asus und wir haben in diesem Fall schon wieder Asus. Sagt mal, Leute, Product Placement ohne Ende. Hier heimliche Werbung. Das Grinsen von dir war auch sehr kurios. Und alles Asus. Als ob Asus der einzige Computer, die einzige Marke wäre, die überall vertreten ist. Hm, sehr seltsam. Oh, die Jungs. Soll sich das mal jemand ansehen?
That's a pretty serious head wound you have there, Tim. Looks like you lost quite a bit of blood. You might want to get that looked at right away.
You know, it must look a lot worse than it feels right now. Honestly, I feel okay. And if you don't mind, I'd like to stay here as long as you might need me.
Sahen Sie, womit Sie geschlagen wurden?
No, I didn't. Whatever it was, knocked me out in one hit.
Können Sie erzählen, was passiert ist?
Mr. Molinas was here awaiting his interview and formal transfer into federal custody. I'd say approximately an hour before the federal authorities were scheduled to arrive, around maybe 8 p.m. or thereabouts, this tall, and if I remember correctly, Hispanic male, wearing a suit, he enters the facility and presents FBI credentials. I turned around to reach for the paperwork, and bam! That's the last thing I remember.
Hä? Wie konnte er so einfach durchkommen? Was passierte, als sie wieder zu sich kam?
I woke up behind the desk here, and then I went to check on the condition of the prisoner. I observed that he'd been shot multiple times, and that he was dead.
What did you do next?
I called it in, tended to my head injury as best I could, and just waited for you guys to show up.
You didn't observe any further sign of the shooter, or whether he had an accomplice.
I didn't see anything. He was long gone, or they were gone. I don't know if he had help. Unfortunately, the assailant disabled our surveillance. He smashed the recording unit to pieces, what's left of that DVR over there.
Können Sie sich an den Namen auf dem Ausweis des Mannes erinnern?
I don't remember the name on the identification. I'm sorry. I thought I got a really good look at it too, because I didn't recognize it, fella. But it's all real foggy to me right now.
Waren Sie alleine?
I understand that this kind of prisoner transfer is on a need-to-know basis, but is it standard operating procedure to post a single guard?
No, it isn't. But in this case, it was necessary because, well, you might find this a little hard to believe, but our budget's been cut pretty radically, so the truth is, we couldn't afford to assign an additional officer. We were definitely whistling through the graveyard, I know that now. Hoping we could get away with this one, but we were wrong.
Who made the final decision that you alone would transport and protect Mr. Molinez?
I did, actually. The sheriff ordered the prisoner transfer, but I'm the sergeant in charge of operational command. That means duty assignments, tactical protocols, and budget outlays. I was the one who evaluated our risk assessment on this one, and I was wrong. Dead wrong.
We all make mistakes, Tim.
Yeah, only this mistake cost a man his life, Mr. Langston.
Wo ist der Sheriff von Pendleton? Oder
When federal authorities need the building, the sheriff and his deputy actually work out of his house. Can you believe that? There's just not much crime here in Pendleton. Not much of anything here, really.
Pendleton, ja, ich habe den Namen falsch ausgesprochen. Konnten Sie sich den Angreifer einprägen?
From what I remember, he was tall. Approximately 6'1", Hispanic male, between 200 and 225 pounds, clean cut. I mean, I don't think he would have caught me off guard if he hadn't looked like a federal prosecutor or FBI agent.
War die Zellentür geöffnet, als Sie den Leichnam fanden?
Nope. After I regained consciousness, I opened up the cell in order to check on the condition of the prisoner. And that's when I observed the multiple bullet wounds to Mr. Molinez and I quickly determined that he had died of those wounds.
Wenn wir mehr Fragen haben, melden wir uns.
Hey, let me know if you find something, okay? Maybe you guys can help save my job.
We'll do our best, Tim. Now, if you don't mind, I'm also a doctor, so I'd like to take a look at your head wound there.
Yeah, okay.
Good news here is you're going to live, but you're going to need stitches. So, now that you've given us your statement, Tim, I am not taking no for an answer. We're going to get you to the hospital.
Okay, I understand. Thanks, Doc.
Wir nehmen das mal zur Sicherheit an uns. Ich habe das Gefühl, dass es wichtig werden könnte.
That's the rag Sergeant Lip applied to his head to staunch the bleeding.
So. Was mich ein wenig überrascht, ist Folgendes. Wie wir sehen, saß er hier und hat die Person auf sich zukommen sehen. Die hat einen Ausweis gezeigt, er hat sich umgedreht, um die Papiere zu holen und wurde von hinten niedergeschlagen. Hat er die Tür offen gelassen, ist die Person schnell ins Zimmer gerannt und hat ihn niedergeschlagen? Da passen die Aussagen nicht zusammen. Das ist zu abstrakt, zu seltsam. Hier stimmt etwas nicht. Sergeant Lips, es tut mir leid, aber ich glaube Ihnen nur so weit, wie ich spucken kann. Und das Spucken ist ein kleiner Verweis auf die Stelle hier am...
Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Molinez was a sitting target in here.
Auf die Stelle hier im Gesicht, wo nämlich scheinbar ihn jemand ins Gesicht gespuckt hat. Aber das schauen wir uns gleich an. Ich will erstmal noch mich hier umschauen. Nee, da haben wir nichts. Dann hier unten wieder Asus. Ja, ja, alles ist Asus. Die haben ein...
This digital recorder stored all the footage from the security cameras in the station. The hard drive's been crushed. We might be able to put it back together at the lab, but it'll probably take weeks to do that, plus salvage any data on it, and that's if we're lucky. I think we might learn more by just putting the case back together. certainly be a better use of our time.
Die haben wohl so einen Hauptvertrag mit Asus. Der ganze Staat Nevada. Es darf überall in jedem Haushalt nur noch Asus stehen. Anders kann ich mir das nicht erklären. Weil so absurde Sachen wie Product Placement oder so Werbegeschichten würden die doch niemals machen. Weil die Leute sich auch total davon beeinflussen lassen.
Looks like a small caliber automatic. A 22, maybe a 25. From what I've observed of the victim's wounds, this could be our murder weapon, but I'm letting myself get ahead of the evidence, aren't I? Let's see what Doc Robbins has to tell us at autopsy.
Ich frage mich, sagt mal, hat irgendwer von euch sich wegen solcher Schleichwerbung in Spielen schon mal ein Produkt gekauft? Ich nicht. Und ich werde es auch nicht, weil solche Schleichwerbung in Spielen für mich überhaupt keine Aussagekraft hat. Ich meine, was soll mir sagen, dass überall Asus steht? Asus ist toll? Woran erkenne ich das, weil überall Asus steht? Na, es könnte auch einfach heißen, Asus ist billig und deshalb wird das vom Staat Nevada eingekauft. Ja, toll. Super Schleichwerbung. Ups, halt. Ich wollte eigentlich links klicken, nicht rechts klicken. Was ist das für ein Zeug?
Yellow powder. We'll want to get that back to the lab. The cell was locked during the shooting. We don't know exactly where the shooter was standing as he fired, but that powder might indicate his position. Well done. I believe we have enough evidence here to begin processing at the lab. It's your call.
Noch nicht ganz. Ich will erst noch die Leiche untersuchen. Oh, das darf ich nicht. Scheinbar muss ich auf Doc Robbins warten. Und er muss uns sagen, dass ihm jemand ins Gesicht gerotzt hat. Na toll. Wäre ja alles andere auch einfacher. Hm. So.
I'll call the coroner to pick up the body.
Na, Doc? Welche Infos hast du für uns?
I'm not quite ready yet. I'll give you a call when I have something for you.
Mensch, in letzter Zeit lässt du aber die Arbeit ein bisschen schludern, ne?
We need to get a reference sample of the ammunition fired by this pistol to compare against the slugs found in the victim. This pistol fires 22 caliber long rifle cartridges. Unfortunately, not a particularly unique type of ammunition. It's a favorite among amateur hunters as well as professional assassins.
Okay, die Munition hilft uns also nicht weiter. Aber wir haben genug andere Beweise, die es können. So.
Since he left it for us, I'm sure Sergeant Lipp wouldn't mind if we processed a sample of his DNA.
Zur Sicherheit. Meine Güte, du. So hier.
It's blood. Sergeant Lipp may have been pistol whipped.
Sag mal, bist du unterbrochen worden? Der gute Langston hat sein...
It's a fragment of some kind. It looks like it got wedged in the slide. Whatever it is, it's underneath the blood. Which means it was there before the blood was.
Da ist er gerade selbst in seiner Aussage unterbrochen worden, so ein bisschen, ne? Hat den Satz nicht vernünftig zu Ende gesagt? Keine Fingerabdrücke auf der Pistole. Das ist die Patrone. Blut, DNA. Das Fragment, okay. Ich würde mal sagen, wir vergleichen zuerst die Chemikalie oder untersuchen die Chemikalie. Ich sollte mal wirklich das Laufrad von dem Hamsterkäfig ölen. Das ist ja furchtbar, was der da für Geräusche im Hintergrund macht. So. Dann das nicht. Das auch nicht. Ja, das sieht ganz okay aus. Das ist auch in Ordnung. Das nehmen wir ebenfalls mit und zuletzt... Nee, das nicht. Aber das. So schon.
Pollen of the Southwestern Wood Lily. This flower is native to Nevada, but it's rare.
Ich wollte sagen, sehr schön und nicht so show. Was ist so show? Oh Gott. Ah, halt.